rise and shine in mate.
What? In mate? What's happening?
Do you know where you are?
I don't remember.
You are in Litchfield Penitentiary.
Prison? No, I'm not a criminal.
No, yes, you are. You are serving time because you insulted another individual.
What? That's crazy. Insulting a person isn't a crime?
It is now. Because this is the future, and personal reputation is more important than personal liberty.
Damn it.
And also, you're pregnant.
What? That's impossible. I'm trans.
Well, in this reality, everyone is trans, and everyone can have babies.
I thought you said this was the future.
Huh?
Well, how long am I in for?
Forever.
Oh, come on! That's not fair!
It is, because this isn't the real you. This is just a copy of your mind that's been uploaded to the cloud. So you're in prison digitally forever in the cloud for all time, pregnant in jail forever. Digitally forever in the cloud.
Well, at least I'm a pretty white girl.
Nuh-uh. Because everyone else is ugly. So in here, ugly is pretty, and pretty is ugly.
Wait, wasn't that an episode of The Twilight Zone?
Yeah, I mean, everybody has computer implants in their eyes that make you look ugly to them.
Okay, that makes sense, contextually.
There are clicks you'll have to navigate.
Clicks? Oh, like the black ladies, the Hispanic ladies, the Russian ladies, like that?
No. Clicks. Everything here is operated by clicking a tiny remote control that you hold in your hand all the time. Really surprising number of things that you can operate just by clicking one tiny little button. It seems impossibly simple, but you'll figure it out.
Well, weird.
And in here, your popularity determines your worth as a human being.
Hang on. Didn't they do that on Community?
Killer bees!
X-Files.
Killer robot bees, though.
Oh, okay.
Also, you're really actually an old man.
What? Oh, I did not see that twist coming.
But you're still pregnant, though.
Oh, nuts.
Reboot.
No, please don't talk about Ghostbusters, because that'll piss me off. No. There was something that was being rebooted with, I think, also The Rock. And I don't know what... Well, don't even... I don't want to talk about
Ghostbusters.
I don't want to talk about Ghostbusters.
Why?
Is it Ghostbusters?
Because it's...
Where did Ghostbusters touch
First of all, I'm so... I'm,
is it
I'm so
it's all
upset
women?
About... No, it's not even
cross the line.
It's not about women. But that's what everybody who... If you have a problem with Ghostbusters, everyone assumes it's because you hate women. And that's not
so
at all it.
Ghostbusters?
Journey to the Center of the Earth 4. How do...
When
did
that
four?
Yeah, when did that happen? Yeah, right?
I feel so bad for Brendan Fraser.
He's doing like Big Trouble in Little China.
This is The Rock?
In the new Highlander reboot.
Wow. How can they reboot Highlander?
There can be only one. That's good. Well, I mean, the thing it is, and this is the thing. Why reboot something that is so good? Like, yeah. Don't reboot something that is amazing. Reboot something that is not good.
Like what?
And make it better.
Coming soon to AMC, a bold reimagining of a television classic.
Back off, Gilligan, or so help me God, I will punch you in the throat!
From the creator of Breaking Bad comes a gripping series critics are already calling the greatest TV show in the world of all time ever, and I haven't even seen it yet.
You sank the boat, bitch!
Coconut milk is the most versatile substance on the planet, and I've been able to cook it to its purest form.
We're partners in the coconut business now?
Killigan knocked down all our huts.
Christ, Killigan, not again. Sorry, bitch.
Let's cook, Killigan. Let's cook coconut.
There's a rescue ship! Should I flag it down?
Yes!
No.
But Professor!
I decide when we're rescued.
But...
I decide!
I watched Marianne drown in the tide pool. I could have saved her. But I didn't.
Look, Professor, if it's money you want, I have plenty. I'm a millionaire.
You think your money is any good here in this place? I made a gun out of a coconut.
People are turning on each other, Professor. I think the skipper has it in for you. You're in terrible danger.
I'm not in danger, Ginger. I am the danger. I'm the one who knocks. If our huts had doors, which is more of a thatched situation right now, but I'm working on that.
If you endanger my crew or my passengers, I will bury you underneath this island.
You think you're still in charge? Your boat is a wreck. You're the captain of jack shit.
Mrs. Howell, there is a part of the coconut that, when processed correctly, becomes one of the more deadly poisons known to man. Just remember that I know that, and that we have a lot of coconuts on this island.
How long could it possibly take to get rescued from this island? It was only a 3-hour tour!
Say my name.
Look,
Say my name.
You're the professor.
You're goddamn right.
Vince Gilligan's Island, coming this fall to AMC.
And now for a brief biblical reenactment. Abraham.
Who is that?
It's me, God.
Oh, my Lord Almighty, I am thy humble servant.
Yeah, awesome. Thanks. Hey, I hereby make this covenant with you.
Me? I am honored, my King of Kings.
I know. So, I want you to cut off the foreskins of all your sons and servants and their sons for all time. Do this, and I will give you the land of Canaan, which will be yours forever and ever, with no problems at all, for all of time, forever.
My God, thank you for this. My people will live in peace for all time. Hang on.
What?
You want us to what?
Which part?
Exactly. You want us to cut off our foreskins?
Oh, yes. Yes, because... for reasons.
What would those reasons be?
Because I'm God and I'm telling you to.
Yeah, but... and just hear me out here. I mean, you made us, right? I mean, if you didn't like foreskins, why didn't you just make us without them?
Oh, well, I like foreskins. I just like to see them cut off.
You're an asshole.
What was that?
Nothing.
And that was a brief biblical reenactment.
I've got my money here.
I'll take mine now, George Bailey.
Oh, no, wait now. You're looking at this place all wrong. Like, I've got your money in a safe in the back. Your money's not here.
Where's my money, George?
Well, now your money's in Joe's house, all right? That's right next to yours. Or in the Kennedy house or Mrs. Maitland's house.
What's my money doing at Joe's house?
Okay, now, it's not literally at Joe's house.
What are you talking about, George?
Well, now, when you put your money into the bank, we don't just hold on to it.
You don't hold on to it.
Well, no. No, we use it to make loans to people, to buy homes and automobiles and such.
I guess that makes sense.
All right.
So, technically, you own our homes, George, until the loans are paid back?
Not always. It's a little more complicated than that.
What do you mean, complicated?
Now, okay, you know I've been helping people buy homes that normally wouldn't be able to afford them, right?
Right, because you're a good man, George. Mm,
thank you. Right, now, but I had to minimize the financial risk to the bank by packaging those loans into various deleveraged mortgage-backed securities.
What are you talking about, George?
Oh, okay, look, now, it's very simple. making loans to people who probably can't afford to pay them back is a very dangerous thing for a bank to do, right? Right? Okay, now, so I had to take those loans and I broke them up into little bits and pieces, which I called collateralized debt obligations, and then I sold those to investors all over the world who wanted to get in on the U.S. housing market, which I told them was very strong.
So, who owns our homes now?
Oh, well, banks and investors all over the world own bits and pieces of it. Now, Fred, a bank in Tokyo, Japan owns your new bathroom. And Wally, an investment firm in India owns your tool shed. Okay, but mostly China, though. China owns a really uncomfortably large percentage of these loans.
What happens to China if the market goes bad, George?
Oh, well, then they'd be pretty well screwed, I guess. No, okay, but that's not going to happen, see? Because home values always go up, right? Okay, and I've been taking all of the building and loans extra capital and investing it in credit default swaps, which Mr. Potter tells me are a very sure thing.
You're taking advice from Henry Potter now, George Bailey?
Now, he is the richest man in Bedford Falls, after all, and he says he's got a plan that'll make the building and loan 18% interest.
That sounds a little too good to be true, George. Oh,
no, it's not at all, no.
What exactly did Mr. Potter tell you, George?
No, well, he said he had the inside track on a series of currency arbitrage investments and some high-yield hedges.
Oh, gosh, George, that sounds an awful lot like a Ponzi scheme.
Right, except we prefer to call it a wealth pyramid. Oh. Right?
Can I still get in on that, George?
Well, sure you can.
I'd like to invest $17.50.
God bless you, Mary.
It's good enough for George Bailey. It's good enough for me.
Oh, well, that's the spirit. Now, who wants a car loan? All right, we get one for you and you, and you can have one, too. Every time someone gets a car loan, an angel gets its wings.
You know, when I was a kid,
Last century?
I know. I'm 108, but when I would crawl in bed with my mom, the television had just been created. But we'd watch American movie classics, and so it was like all black and white movies. So, like, I thought being a movie star meant you talk like this.
Right.
Like, yeah. That's the way it happened. Once you grew up, you became in movies. And then
it would be just like Myrna Loy.
Exactly. I was acting. Myrna Loy, Claudette Colbert. These were the biggest stars my age. And all my friends were like, who the
I have never actually seen It's a Wonderful Life.
Whoa! Oh.
Yeah. All right, we're leaving.
All I knew of it was really the Simpsons episode where there's
Are you
like.
Serious?
That's a lot
of
people
in Star Wars.
You've seen it since, though.
Well, yeah, well, I went home and watched, first of all, the bank run scene, and then as much of the rest of it as I could.
Wait, as much as you could?
No, I started with the bank scene because I knew that was, look, sketch is tricky. And
a kid goes deaf in his ear.
Oh, is that in the movie?
Yes!
No.
It happens in
you
the first 10 minutes
of
much of a spoiler.
Movie.
It is so
I will,
good.
I've seen it.
No, you haven't, though.
You haven't.
You
know
that.
Travis. Everybody knows that.
An angel gets its wings, Travis.
I know that. That's one of those things.
Ernie came from that movie.
We know what I love about those days. Your voice, and you know your.
Is this yours?
No, Dad's not.
Your mother said she saw you watching it.
A couple of the guys must have.
Must have what?
I don't know.
Where
Dad,
did you get it?
I don't know.
Answer me! Who taught you how to use this?
You, alright? I learned it from watching you!
Parents who use VHS have children who use VHS. Please, talk to your kids about streaming video.
Oh my God, is that a yes?
This is a yes!
So, we're gonna do this. You're gonna move in? Okay, because that is like, oh, awesome. That is so, you know? Woo!
You know what I'm thinking? Here's what I'm thinking. Let's do a secret spill.
I don't know what that is, but it sounds hot.
No. What I mean is maybe we tell each other all the things that we don't know about each other so that when we eventually do move in together, there's no surprises or secrets. And it doesn't even have to be that big. Look, it could be something like, I don't like dogs, you know, simple like that. I'll go first. I don't like dogs.
Okay. Well, oh, I don't even know what to say because, you know, I try not to keep secrets from you, you know? Okay, here's one. I eat glass.
You eat glass?
Well, I guess have eaten. I have eaten glass. It's a small but important distinction. Okay, your turn.
Okay, okay, here's a funny one. Sometimes when I'm really, really tired and I get home late from work, I don't really feel like taking my makeup off, so I just go to sleep with it on, and it gets all over the pillowcase. But don't worry, I always clean the pillowcase every time I wake up in the morning.
Wasn't even a little bit worried. Okay, my turn. I used to be a man. Your turn.
You mean you used to be a woman?
If you'd let me finish, maybe your next secret reveal should be that you always interrupt people.
You were clearly finished. You said your turn.
Okay, miss, I need to be right all the time. Now we're just arguing semantics. If you had let me finish, I would have clarified and said I was born a man, but then I switched to being a woman in the 90s because what else was I gonna do? And then I switched back to being a man. Your turn.
Okay, I clip my toenails in the living room while watching TV.
Gross. I don't like chocolate.
Okay, see? Now that is tame, borderline normal.
Unless it is formed in the shape of cute little forest animals like bunnies or fawns that I can bite the cute little heads right off of. You see what happens when you interrupt people? Your turn.
You know what? I think that secret spill time is over. I'm all secreted out, and I think we should move on. So
actually,
let's...
you know what? I have this list of secret spill secrets that I thought maybe we should just go through together.
Wait, what? You said that you didn't know what secret spill was.
Oh, I guess maybe you should just take a gander at number 13 then.
I often lie about my knowledge of secret spills.
So just let me go ahead and shoot through the rest of these. I'll just go over the main ones. I ask people for money claiming I have medical problems when in fact I'm spending the money to research a book I'm writing called Why Do We Cook Bacon and Bake Cookies? Think about that. I once spent a week convinced I was a pair of shorts. I once tried to smother you to death while you were sleeping, but you woke up and I covered by saying I love you for the first time. The following are things I don't believe actually exist. Computers, tissue paper, Jack Nicholson, and Alaska. When I was a kid, I would read Superman comics, but I always thought it was Supperman, and I was like, what gives you the right to be all British and uppity? Well, just call yourself Dinner Man, you jackass. But then I realized my mistake, and I was all like, oops. Yep, I once abducted some aliens. And last but not least, I really, really, really enjoyed the movies Geely and Glitter and am currently penning scripts for their sequels.
Okay. Wow. That's a lot to take in. Okay. Wow. I just said that. Because wow. Okay. Yeah. I can deal with that. I mean, there's a lot that we need to work on. I mean, the whole Geely Glitter thing, but I really do love you, and that's all that matters. And if I can't accept you for who you are, then what's the point, you know? The only thing that matters is that we love each other.
Oh, that was beautiful. I don't think this is gonna work out.
What?
I mean, seriously, you don't like any dogs?
When we think of secrets or things revealed to you, I'm thinking of some stuff. I'm like, yeah, if I found out some stuff, you know, but usually they're all like depressing or negative-y or like bummers, right? And I'm just like, what are secrets out there that are like innocuous? You know what I mean? Like, Or is there someone out there that's just like, I love taffy and I'm not telling anybody?
You don't tell anybody, you don't get taffy.
Yeah, exactly. You want to tell. Yeah. I mean, that's assuming you have people in your life who want to do nice things for you. Yeah. Do you guys, like, if you get into major relationships, do you share secrets snuggling in bed?
And I have to keep my shit tight and just hold it back and not, mm-hmm. you know, ever be vulnerable ever. Right? So,
no, I'm the same way. I'm completely secretive about unbelievably stupid things that are like, they don't need to be private. I don't like people
what?
I'm dating to know where I live.
That's just common sense.
We might break up. I don't know where they're. I don't know them. Yeah. Like 3 days.
It might
later.
Take me well, 5 years to break up with you, and I don't want you coming over here for.
Yeah,
five.
I don't know.
Not one
I
of my girlfriends has ever let me know where her clitoris is.
That's a negative secret.
Just fill that in and come back, honey. Next, honey, that's you. Come on.
Sorry. Hi. I tried to get into a club last night, and they said I couldn't go in because I didn't have my gay card.
Oh, yeah. I hear they're cracking down on that.
They are. Oh. Okay. Well, can I get my gay card here?
Oh, no. Maybe you have to be gay to get a gay card.
What? No. Yeah. I figured. I am.
Oh, sweetie, I wasn't clear. You have to be gay.
I understand what you're saying. I am gay. I'm a gay guy.
No, I don't mean gay as in happy, the way the word was used in olden times. I mean gay, like homosexual. Boys that like other boys.
I get it. Yes, I am that. I had a boyfriend for like 2 years.
Had?
Yeah.
You're not together anymore?
Well, no.
Because you're not gay?
No, for other reasons, okay, that I don't really want to go into with a complete stranger.
Honey, I'm going to need you to bring it down and step aside while you come to terms with your sexuality. I have other people in line.
There's two.
Next.
Fine.
Hi. I just got back from a 5-year contract with Atlantis Cruises. But now I'm being told I have to have a gay card in order to even get in the pleasure chest.
Mm-hmm. But you can't have one.
Well, I just heard you tell that breeder that you just have to be gay in order to get one.
That is one requirement, yes, sir.
Well, hello!
I can't give you a card because you are too gay.
What?
See, right there. That's just what I'm talking about.
What do you mean I'm too gay?
You're giving us a bad name. You're too flouncy.
Oh, no, you didn't.
It scares the straights, okay? Maybe you just try and tone it down some, and I'll be happy to reconsider your application. Next.
Oh. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3. Turn back till I know.
Hello and greetings and salutations.
It's such an honor to have you here. What can I do for you? Do you need a gay card?
I'm told I need one to attend my own concert. It's shiny golden ticket rainbow dancing, wrapped in clear.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Let me just get that for you and done. Here you go, Sia.
Exalted expression of gratitude, kosher goddess.
I'm gonna swim from the chandelier, from the chandelier.
Wow. Hey, wait a minute.
What the hell?
Sia isn't even gay.
Yeah, Sia isn't even gay. So what are you doing giving her a gay card when we couldn't even get one?
Oh. Well, she's famous.
What? That's not fair. Yeah, I can't believe you'd bend the rules for someone just because they're famous.
We make an exception for Sia and Beyonce and Justin Timberlake. We'd make an exception for Bieber, but we don't have to. Next!
Wait. Justin Bieber is gay? That is... Also, I love that guy. He is such an amazing artist.
Yeah, that is the gayest thing I have ever heard.
So gay. My bad. Here you go, sir.
Thank you.
Lunch break.
The gayest.